The purpose of this course that consists of three parts is to understand how Thea works and get comfortable with the user interface. The first part deals mostly with the user interface and basic workflows. In the second part, we will be working on an exterior scene where we will be learning materials, environment, adding Thea models, display settings, and more. In the third and last part, we will be creating a day and night rendering of the interior, and we'll be talking about importing models, setting up the lighting for both day and night, working with the Relight editor, controlling the camera, and finally scene settings and batch rendering. After watching these three parts, you will have a very good knowledge on how to work with Thea and create amazing renderings. But first of all, let's talk about the Thea render toolbar. If you do not see it, you can bring it up by going to Extensions, Thea Render, Show Thea for SketchUp toolbar. To start rendering with Thea, we need to open the control panel with a click on the rendering window icon. This also brings up the rendering window, but we can close it for now. The Thea render engine works in two modes, interactive and production mode. The toggle button that lets you switch between the two is this button here. Let's first talk about interactive rendering. To start interactive rendering, we first make sure that the switch is enabled and that Presto is the selected engine. Click on the Start button and Thea will start rendering in the SketchUp window. There are several display modes while in interactive mode, but those that have to do with the SketchUp window are the last four. We will not be explaining every display mode, but only those that we will be using the most. In SketchUp with edges displays the rendered image along with the edges of the model, which can be extremely useful when you want to select, modify objects and create new ones. In SketchUp window is the same as the previous one, but without the edges. There is another option called in Thea window, which uses the rendering window to display the rendered image. Switching to this display mode will bring up the rendering window in interactive mode. This mode can be useful when you have multiple monitors and want to keep working on the SketchUp model while displaying the rendered image on a separate screen. In the latest version of Thea Render, it is possible to use the denoisers while rendering in interactive mode. Systems having an NVIDIA graphics card should use the NVIDIA denoiser since it is more interactive. To enable interactive denoising, we need to open the Thea tool panel and from the Display tab, select NVIDIA from the drop-down and tick the checkbox. Next, we will learn how to switch to production mode in order to create final renderings. When Thea runs in production mode, it means that any change to the scene will not affect the image while rendering. We can switch to production mode by clicking the toggle button. When this button is gray, it means that Thea is running in production mode. The final size of the rendered image can be defined in the Camera tab of the Thea Tools panel. Before clicking on the Start button, we can also set the termination criteria, which can be defined either by sample or time. Basically, we can set limits to the Thea engine and tell it when to stop rendering. We can set both limits and whichever comes first. In this case, we set a limit of 128 samples. Zero in any case means infinite and hence not used. Let's hit Start. As you can see, once the engine reaches 128 samples, it stops rendering. One important thing to note here is that the termination criteria also affect interactive rendering. Now that we have seen the rendering window, also called darkroom, let's learn a few things about it. There are three buttons on the top right corner which provide additional functionality. The first one is called Expensive Preview. This button turns on or off computational heavy effects such as denoising or glare while rendering, and applies them after the image has finished rendering. This means that if you have enabled denoising, while rendering you will see the rendered image without the effect. At any point you can click on this button to turn it on and see all the effects being applied while rendering. The second button displays a histogram of the rendered image. The last one is the Render Region option. Click on this button to see the cursor changing to a crosshair, drag an area that you would like to re-render, and click on the Start button. Use this option when you want to re-render parts of the image that have small changes. Investigate optimal samples limit for the whole image using the noisiest region as a test area, or when you want to see a part of the image being rendered with more samples. Click on the same button again to remove the render region. Let's also have a look at resume rendering. Let's assume that we rendered an image with a low number of samples, and we now want to add more. With resume rendering, there is no need to start the rendering from scratch. Select how many samples you want to add. Hold down Ctrl on the keyboard and click on the Start button. This will force the Thea render engine to keep the rendered image and continue adding new samples to the image. One last thing worth mentioning is the Live Update functionality. This option can be found right next to the Start button. When enabled, all the changes are immediately applied to the already rendered model, same way as when interactive rendering is running. Let's follow an example. Live Update is enabled and we will render for the first time. The first time it takes around 17 seconds to transfer the whole scene. Let's make a few changes to the scene and try rendering again. There was no model conversion time and the rendering started immediately. This can also be useful when you are working in interactive mode, making changes to the scene, and then you need to render in production mode. The scene conversion time is instant in this case too. Visibility changes are currently not supported. Also, in cases where you are making drastic changes to the model, it is better having the option disabled as it may slow down the modifications done in SketchUp. We are now ready to move on to the second part, where we will be rendering an exterior scene.